गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, 12th क्लास अकाउंटेंसी। चैप्टर 2 एंड द टॉपिक इज फिक्स्ड कैपिटल अकाउंट, योर फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड। आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट पार्टनर्स कैपिटल अकाउंट कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय फॉलोइंग टू मेथड्स, फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल मेथड एंड फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड। Fluctuating already we have done yesterday, so today we will be talking about fixed capital method. Under fixed capital account, two accounts are prepared instead of preparing one account. Which two accounts? Fixed capital method, capital account and current account. These two accounts will be prepared by following fixed capital method. So what is the difference here in capital account and in current account? Fixed capital means the capital of the partners, capital of partners will remain fixed, as the name implies. Fixed means fixed. Fixed means there will be no change in the partner's capital. As you have seen in the previous method, that partner's capital is changed with every transaction. Like if there is a salary, then partner's capital will increase. If there is IUC, partner's capital will increase. Share of profit, it will also increase the partner's capital. Interest on drawing, decrease in the capital. But under the fixed capital method, capital will remain same. It is not necessary that every time always it will remain same. It may change, but there will be only two reasons with which it will be changing. So this can be the very important one marker question. List down the reasons with which the fixed capital may change. It may change. So what are the reasons you can note down?
Additional capital.
Yes, when the additional capital is introduced, additional capital is introduced. Suppose in the beginning of the year, you were having 5 lakh rupees. And during the year on 1st October, partner A has introduced, Ronak, please pay attention. Yes, Ronak. Partner A has introduced rupees 1 lakh. So this will be known as additional capital. So if any additional capital is introduced, then it will be changed. At the year end, that partner capital will become 6 lakh. 5 lakh was the initial capital and during the year, he has introduced rupees 1 lakh. And one another reason is there, but before going to that reason, wait a minute, Hitesh. Before going to that reason, I would like to explain you the concept of drawing. Listen to carefully. In 11th, we have studied that drawings are only of one type. Drawings. We have studied only the word drawing. But in 12th class, drawing can be of two types. Make this web chart and it can be a very important one marker question. Drawings out of capital. Drawings out of capital and drawings out of profit. Out of capital, drawings out of capital are also known as permanent drawings. The alternate name of this is permanent drawings. Permanent drawings means you have withdrawn your capital and you are never going to refund it. Suppose earlier you were having 5 lakh capital and the firm is continuously suffering from losses. So you are not much interested in continue that business. So you have decided to reduce the share of capital so that you are not going to bear much losses. Okay, so you have withdrawn rupees 2 lakh from your capital and this will be known as drawings from capital. Drawings from capital means you are not going to refund it. This is a permanent drawings. For always you have withdrawn your capital. So this type of drawings are known as permanent drawings. And on these drawings, no IOD is charged. One marker, very important question. Sometimes permanent drawings are also given in the question, but there you have to remember that if it is mentioned that partner A has withdrawn rupees 2 lakh out of capital, means he is not going to repay that amount. So if the interest on drawing rate is given, so in that case, you are not going to charge any interest on permanent drawings. Why? Because this money will never be repaid to the firm. It was his money and he has taken it back, and accordingly, his share in the profits will be reduced. But no interest on drawing can be charged on permanent drawings. Second drawing is out of profits. These are the drawings which are done from the profits, not from the capital. Suppose a partner is in emergency need of some money. Suppose 50,000, he has to pay his son or daughter fees and he is not having any money, he's short of money. So in that case, he can withdraw some amount from his business, but with a condition that he is going to repay it to the firm after maybe after 1 year, 6 months, 2 years. And on this amount, he is supposed to pay interest on drawing. So interest on drawing will be charged only on the drawings out of profits, not on the drawings out of capital. Clear? Interest on drawing will be charged only on the drawings out of profit, not from the drawings out of capital. This is a very important one marker question. And which drawings will be refunded? Again, one marker question. Out of profits drawings will be refunded to the firm, and until they are refunded, the partner need to pay interest on drawings. Jab tak partner usko wapis nahi kar dega, tab tak usko pay karna hai. But suppose at the time of withdrawing the amount, he has made it clear that I am making the drawing out of capital. He has made it clear, out of capital. It means two things are clear here. First, no interest on drawing will be charged. Second, he is not going to repay. Suppose in future, if he wants to bring some additional money again, so that amount can be brought in the business only in the form of additional capital, not in the form of drawing is refunded. Clear? So no interest on drawing will be given on the drawings out of capital. And definitely after a certain period, drawings out of profits will be refunded by the partner. So that amount will be coming to the firm back. It's clear. But suppose you are doing a question and in that question drawings are given. Now listen carefully, because in this chapter there are so many assumptions. So it is mentioned that drawings of partner A 50,000, and the nature of drawing is not mentioned in the question. Nature of means whether it is a drawing out of capital or drawing out of profit. It is not mentioned in the question. So what you will do then? So in that case, we will assume that these drawings are drawings out of profit. Note down, drawings out of profit. If the nature of drawing is not mentioned, then we will assume, Dhruv Bansal, your camera is again and again still in still mode. I will be removing you. So make sure, again, it is not going to the still mode. Otherwise, I will remove. Yes. So if question is silent about the nature of drawing, then we will assume that drawings are out of profit. It means until or unless it is mentioned in the question, you cannot assume the drawings out of capital. If the drawings are out of capital, then it must be mentioned very clearly in the question. Drawings out of capital, either this line will be written or he has withdrawn capital. This line will be written. Withdrawn capital means drawings out of capital. So now get back to the topic. This was the nature and the types of drawing. So we were doing the fixed capital method. So capital, fixed capital means capital will remain same. It may change only with the two conditions. What are those two conditions? When additional capital is introduced. And second condition is when permanent drawings are made. Permanent drawings are made. Permanent drawings are made. Clear? So these are the two conditions, very important one marker question. with which the fixed capital account of a partner may change. First, an additional capital is introduced. Second, when capital is withdrawn permanently, means permanent drawings are made. So these are the only two situations. And with the due to the change in profit and loss appropriation account or due to the transactions in profit and loss appropriation account, their capital account will never change. So whatever the entries we have recorded in the P&L appropriation account relating to the partners will be recorded in the current account. So that's why I told you that in fixed capital account, two accounts are prepared. Now I am making the format. Two accounts are prepared. Which two accounts I am making here? First account, suppose there are only two partners, partner A and B, and they are following fixed capital method. So they must be preparing two accounts. First account is the partner's capital account. Please make the format, everyone. Yes, this is the partner's capital account, debit credit, particulars, A, B, particulars. Keshav, you are not writing anything. And even you are not in uniform. And now don't make faces. I can remove you right now. Because many times I have told that uniform is compulsory. Then on every alternate day, day before yesterday or before that day, you were again, you were not in uniform. So it's your regular practice. So make sure from Monday onwards, if you are attending the class, then be on time and be on uniform. Otherwise, I am not going to allow you. A and B. So buy balance BD. This is the opening balance again. Please make the format, everyone. And then buy cash. Buy cash means additional capital. If a partner is introducing the additional capital, then in credit side it will be recorded. Buy capital, additional capital. Here. Now come to the debit side to cash. It is the permanent drawing. Now I will be telling you two, three important questions in relation to the fixed capital account. Permanent drawings, because whenever we will be drawing the capital, the journal entry pass will be capital account debit to cash. Capital account debit to cash, or what we can do, capital account debit, drawings account, capital account debit to drawings, and the second entry will be drawings to cash. So it's up to you whether you want to pass a single entry or double entry. So to cash, and this is the balance CD. Balance CD means closing balance. So this is the format of the fixed capital account only. Always one marker question, that what are the items written on the debit side of the fixed capital account? So only two items are always there. Only two. It can be one. If there are no permanent drawings, it can be one. But if there are permanent drawings, then maximum number of items in the debit side of fixed capital account is two. Which two? Permanent drawings and closing balance. You are not going to write balance CD. It will be wrong. If two items are asked, then two items are permanent drawings. Permanent drawings means the drawings which are done out of capital. And second is closing balance of capital. And on the credit side, how many items are recorded? Again, two items. First is the opening balance and second one is the additional capital. But suppose in a year, there is no additional capital in the business, no additional capital and no permanent drawings. So what will be the closing balance of the partner's capital? Could you please tell me? There is no additional capital introduced. Suppose
opening balance to closing balance.
Yes. Then what will be the closing balance of partners' capital?
So opening balance.
The opening balance.
Yes. Very good. Please take initiative and give answer. Please. Otherwise, you will be not developing the analyzing and thinking skills, which are most required. Yes. So there will be no figure here as well as no figure here. So it means the opening balance and closing balance will remain same. So again, very important one marker question. Can the opening balance and closing balance of partners remain same? Yes. Then in what method? Only in the fixed capital method, not in the fluctuating capital method. Because in fluctuating capital method, there must be some profit or loss at the end of the year. So that just because of that profit or loss, their closing balance will be changing. There may not be salary, may not be IOC, may not be IOD, but still at the end of the year, there must be either profit or loss. So in that case, their capital account will change. So in fixed capital account, opening balance can be equal, closing balance can be equal to opening balance. Yes, it's true. When there is no additional capital and no permanent drawings. And rest all the items which we did yesterday, rest all the items will be recorded in the current account. Okay, now I am making the current account. There is no change in the format of the current account. It will be prepared in the same manner as we were preparing capital accounts, but current account. So this is the particulars. Write down the current account, and this is the debit balance. This is the credit balance. A, B, again particulars. A and B. So here it will be again starting with the balance BD. So balance of what? Here we have written the balance of capital. Here we are going to write the balance of current account. It may be given in the question, it may not be given. If it is given, then it will be started. Keshav, your video is still. So if it is given in the question, then you are going to start with this only. So balances, opening balances. And if the debit side, asset side, the balances are given, then you are going to write this side. To balance BD. So this is the liability side balance and this is the asset side balance. And it is not necessary that these balances are given in the question. It may be given, it may not be given. Aisa bhi ho sakta hai ki do mein se ek partner ka current account given hai aur dusre ka given hi nahi. So you have to react according to the question. Okay. Then all the items which yesterday we wrote in the P&L appropriation account will be recorded now in the current account. In fluctuating method, everything was written in the capital account itself, but in fixed method, the all items of P&L appropriation will be recorded only in the current account. Yes. Yeah. So what are those items? By IOC, all the items of P&L appropriation. By salary, what are the amounts? Suppose both have got the IOC, partner B has got the salary. So partner A will be left blank. Then by commission, only suppose partner A has received the commission and B has not received any commission. Then the last item was by P&L appropriation. And this was the profit, their share in profit. So they both must be getting their share. And on this side, two drawings. Which drawings will be coming here? Now you can see that here also we have wrote the drawings and here also I am writing the drawings. So what are the type of this drawing? This is the drawings out of profits. These are known as also temporary drawings. And these are known as permanent drawings. These are known as temporary drawings. So drawings out of profit will be written in the current account. Again, a very important one marker question. Drawings out of capital are given in the question and it is asked from you that under fixed capital method, where these drawings will be recorded. So your answer will be, if it is out of capital, then your answer will be under capital account. And if it is mentioned that drawings are out of profit, then your answer will be it will be recorded in current account. Here, so if the concept is clear, then in any format you can give the answer. So that's why knowledge of format is very important. So here you are going to write the permanent drawings and here temporary drawings on which you are supposed to pay the interest on drawings. So again here interest on drawing will be coming, because if drawings are there, then there must be interest on drawing. Drawing alone cannot be there. Here, and the last item, to profit and loss appropriation account. What is this? This is the loss of profit and loss appropriation. Here, losses are always debited, so that's why it has come on the debit side. Then the finally, we are going to balance it. So that will be balance CD. And this will be known as closing balance. But make sure in capital account, under fixed capital method, in capital account, there will be always credit balance. Always credit balance. Right here. In your format, right here, it's again a very important one marker question. Yesterday, I told you, in fluctuating method, capitals may have debit balance as well as credit balance. But under fixed capital method, capital always will have credit balance. Credit balance means credit side will be more. Okay. So under fluctuating method, capital may be having debit balance as well as credit balance. But under fixed capital method, capital must have only the credit balance. It will be never having the debit balance. It's really a very important one marker question. And current account, which balance current account have? It is again a very important one marker question. Which balance current accounts have? So your answer will be debit as well as credit. Both balance. If it has the debit balance, then it will be recorded in the debit side of the balance sheet. And if it has the credit balance, then it will be recorded on the liability side, because all the credit balances are recorded on the liability side. So two balance CD, closing balance I have mentioned here. Now, here also, this side also, I am writing the balance CD. By balance CD. This is the closing balance. It means, partner, suppose partner A is having a debit balance of rupees 50,000 and partner B is having the credit balance of 60,000. It may also happen that one partner balance you are getting on the debit side and the other partner balance you are getting on the credit side. And you all know how to balance the accounts. You are going at the end of the account, you are going to do the additions of both the sides. Then the lesser side will be subtracted from the more side and the balance will be written on the lesser side. You are going to write the balance on the lesser side. So current accounts have both side balance. Either debit side balance and or credit side balance. So this is all about the current account. So the only difference in the current account which you can see and the capital account is this. In capital account, only the four items are recorded which are related to basically change in the capital. And for all the reasons with which during the year capital may change are recorded in the current account. But when we are following the fluctuating method, then this difference will be removed. All the items which we have written in the capital account as well as in the current account will be written all together in one format. Then that format will be known as capital account. So we can say, wait a minute. We can say under fluctuating method, fixed capital account plus current account. All the items are written together to make it fluctuating capital account. Means in fixed capital account, we are recording all these things separately. We are making two accounts, but under fluctuating capital, we are making only one account. That account is known as capital. Clear? Now I'm going back to the PDF. Wait a minute. So this is all about the current account and capital account. Capital account is debited with the additional capital. introduced and it is credited with the additional capital introduced and debited with the drawings against capital or out of capital or permanent drawing. And in current account, again it can be asked, what are the debit side items of the current account? So there are the three items in the debit side of the current account. Which three? Drawings against profit, interest on drawing, share of loss. And it is credited with salary, commission, IOC and share of profit. And current account may have both the balances, debit or credit. So now you can see one format of the current account. Wait a minute. This is the partner's capital account, fluctuating capital account. This is the partner's current fixed capital method, which I have drawn. Now you can see from PDF, this is the opening balance, additional capital, permanent drawings, closing capital. Always only four items will be there, maximum four, maybe two or three, but maximum four. And this is the current account, credit balance, this side will be written, IOC, commission, salary, P&L appropriation profit. And if debit balance are there, this side will be written, drawings against profit, interest on drawings, profit and loss, balance CD, and the balance may be on the opposite side if the amount is overdrawn. So this is all about today's topic. I hope I am clear.